Let us now do an experiment related to partition chromatography. Here we will use paper chromatography as an example for that. As you know that we have paper here and the mixture to be separated. So after knowing the terms stationary phase and mobile phase, are you ready to start with me this activity, this experiment? So I have here with me this circular Wattman filter paper. Here we will use this filter paper, and can you guess what will be the solid support or stationary support here, stationary phase here to be more accurate?
Is it a paper?
See, you have made a mistake. Though it's a paper, it seems to be to most of the people that paper is a stationary phase. No, it is actually the water which has been already there in the pores of this paper acts as a stationary phase. So stationary phase is water here, not the paper. So that should be very clear to you. And then this is the mixture here I have of the compounds which is to be separated. What I will do here is I will first make a hole in the center of this paper, exactly in the center, with the help of this oil pin, right? And then I will use this mixture to be separated with the help of this capillary. I will take very small amount of this liquid and make a spot at the center of the paper where I had made a hole with the help of this oil pin. I let this spot dry completely. And then you can see here we have a wick made of cotton. Okay. Now with this wick, we will place this wick at the center of the filter paper where the spot has already been made there and has already been dried. We'll place that wick at the center of the filter paper. Now again I have with me here this development chamber or the developing chamber. You can see here some liquid is there down in this, and that is our mobile phase. So depending upon what compounds are to be separated, we choose our mobile phase here in the development chamber. You want to ask something?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Shailja.
Do these components separate between these two phases?
Actually, you see it's a partition process, right? The substances which are to be separated or which get separated partition themselves between the two phases, the stationary and the mobile. The mobile phase, since it is a moving phase, as you know, it carries with it the two separated components in a different rates, you can say. The components move along with the mobile phase at different rates. The one component which is more soluble in the mobile phase will move faster than the other one, which will be left behind, and you will see two clear zones of separation, one compound moving ahead of the other. That's why you will get in the final result the two components separated in at the two separate places. So mobile phase carries along with it the two components of the mixture differentially means at different rates. That is why they get separated. Any other doubt you have, Satinder, or anything else you want to know, Shailja?
Ma'am, how would we perform this experiment?
So let us do that. I think you are very curious and
yes,
interested to know this. So let us start doing this experiment on paper chromatography. For this, as I have already told you, we will take this circular Wattman filter paper, and with the help of this oil pin, I am going to make a pin hole at the center of this filter paper. See, I have made a hole, pin hole at the center, and this is a wick of cotton. I will now insert this wick into this pin hole. Again, I will take the help of this pin. So our mixture of compounds is already there on this filter paper like this, and here is the developing chamber. You can see here that we have prepared a developing chamber wherein we have put in two petri dishes, one at the bottom and one at the top, and this is covered, and in between the two there is a solvent which is the mobile phase, right. What we will be doing is we will be putting this paper into this developing chamber. I will put this developing chamber here very carefully, and why we have covered this chamber is that this chamber should be saturated with the vapors of the solvent, whatever solvent we are taking in. So, you should be very clear that whenever you prepare a developing chamber like this, you have to keep the solvent in the lower petri dish for quite some time, maybe 15 to 20 minutes, so that it gets saturated with the vapors of the solvent or the mobile phase. Now, I will carefully take this filter paper, put this dish a little while here, and then very carefully put this filter paper here, and then cover again very quickly. Now you can see that the lower part of the wick is already dipping in the water, which is the solvent we have taken for this mixture, and water will rise slowly from that wick by the capillary action, and then it will touch the spots of the mixture, and it will differentially take along with it different components of this mixture. Just keep observing this filter paper. You will see that solvent will start moving. So, we have taken this filter paper out, and I am removing this wick from here, and now you can see that there is a clear separation of different colors. That means different colored compounds have separated by the use of paper chromatography. You can see all different rings are there. One is pink colored, inside there is a bluish color, and the outer rim is of a mix of little of greenish and brown color. So, those two compounds are not very clearly separated, but here you can see pink and this green and blue are very clearly separated by this technique. So, we will let this filter paper dry, and you can see here that after drying the colors will be very clearly visible to you. So, now can you tell me how did you find this experiment of paper chromatography?
Ma'am, this was very simple and easy.
What about you? You also enjoyed?
Ma'am, yes ma'am, it is a so simple experiment. Ma'am, I have thought that this would be difficult, but ma'am, it was so simple, and the color are separated so beautifully. It looks amazing.
Yes ma'am, it is so good.
So, you can see that the separation has been very clear. Apparatus was very simple, almost no cost you can say was involved as compared to the kind of separations we are able to achieve by this method. Very simple, very easy, very less time consuming, and that was the purpose to tell you by the simple techniques also we can do wonders with chromatography. So, you have seen today that we were able to separate a mixture of compounds into different components using paper chromatography, and since this experiment was really interesting, I hope you must have enjoyed learning this activity. And now at the end, can you now tell me what did you learn in this experiment?
Yes ma'am, today we have learnt a method chromatography, which means a separation of different components present in a mixture, and for the purpose of separation, purification and identification of the different components present in mixture.
And ma'am, this technique was used in past, but it is still relevant today.
Yes, very good. So, you have learned this partition chromatography, and in the next session, which will be still very, very interesting and more interesting even, I would say, will be the experiments based on adsorption chromatography, and we will be performing thin layer chromatography and column chromatography, two more techniques based on the adsorption mechanism. It's a little different kind of chromatography, still a chromatographic technique, and we will achieve the same functions, the same objectives of separation of the compounds, purification of the compounds, and identification of course will be there, but in a different form that you will realize and appreciate. So till then, we will be meeting in the next session. Goodbye.
Thank you, ma'am.